My name is Sneha. Welcome to the Ayurvedic Institute, like a little webinar of information, and hopefully this is helpful for each of you. And then today, Nishita was going to join us, who's our admissions director, but she had a family health emergency, so she's helping to support individuals. So sending our love and prayer, so that's why she's not here. Usually she would be here as well. But I'm sure she will schedule another one with you guys because she loves doing this as well. But sending our, you know, prayers and love for the family that she is supporting right now as well. Well, let's get started. I'd like to start off with like a little class prayer, if that's okay with everyone. This is one of the prayers that we say when we begin all of our classes at the Ayurvedic Institute as well. A little prayer to Ganesh, to Saraswati, and to the guru, the teacher. And just to give a little brief explanation too. So when we say Ganesh, and when we say any of these prayers, actually, we tell all of our students, you know, our current students and prospective students, that you don't have to be Vedic based, you don't have to be Hindu, you don't have to be a particular religion, but there is a beautiful foundation of spirituality within our school. And we are just open to anything and everything. And essentially, when we say these prayers, these sutras, these Sanskrit chants, the mantras, what we're doing is actually invoking a collective energy. So when we talk about the energy of Ganesh, represents so many things, but also just he is like all that is, the universe, the divinity, the light, and remover of all obstacles. So we're always just wishing that for each of us to embody that. And then when we talk about the energy of Saraswati represents the energy of like education, of wisdom, of knowledge. So especially when we say these at the beginning of our classes is to help all of us get in touch with that energy as we have that transmission of education, energy, dialogue, discussion between student and teacher. And then the last one is the energy of the guru, which is teacher. And when we say teacher, not like the teacher that is lecturing in front of that classroom in that moment, because we're all the same when we're there together, we're learning together, we're discussing together, but really that true divine teacher and whatever that may be for you. And I love the way Dr. Ladd says, it may be an actual like master teacher that you have been with, or it is like that true divine teacher that resides in all of us, right? That impermanent, like, light that is always there that we can all tap into at all times. So it's not necessarily towards any one particular individual or any one particular religion. So let's get started with that. And if you like to, depending on where you are, please just find yourself in a comfortable position. If you are seated, if you are on the floor, if you are on your bed, in a chair, wherever that may be, legs can be crossed, they can be out open. The idea is to have this comfortable position where you can just let go, relax, and receive. And then just, you know, if there's something in your hands, if you're going to take notes or something, just put all that stuff aside. And then if you need a little grounding energy this morning, go ahead and put the palms kind of face down if you like, just to offer a little bit more like grounding, nurturing energy. And if you need a little bit more enlightening energy of a little bit more space, a little bit more activity in the body, then you can have the palms facing up. And then otherwise, any mudra, any way that is comfortable for you. And then slowly just go ahead and close your eyes and take a nice deep breath in through the nose and a deep exhalation out through the mouth. And one more deep breath in and a deep exhalation, just releasing everything. Om. Om gananam tva ganapatim havamahe. Kavim kavinam upama shravastamam jeshtarajam brahmanam brahmanaspata anaha
Shrunvanu Dibihi Sida Sadhanam Vakratunda Mahakaya Suryakoti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada Siddhi Buddhi Shakti Sahita Sriman Mahaganadipataye Namo Namaha Nirvignam Kuru. Yakundendu Tushara Hara Davala Yashubravastravruta Yavina Varadanda Manditakara Yashweta Padmasana Ya Brahma Chuta Shankara Prabhutir Bihir Devai Sada Vandita Samam Patu Saraswati Bhagavati Nishesha Jadya Patha Gurura Brahma Gurura Vishnu Gurura Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Shakshat Parabrahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Slowly just take a deep breath in and a nice deep exhalation. Namaste. You can slowly open your eyes when you are ready.
Well, welcome, friends. So this also gives you a little insight into like who we are and what we are about. And, you know, some of the nuances of our institution. You know, there's so many beautiful institutions out there, but everyone is a little different. And one thing I would really want to share with you today is some of the differences of like who we are and why we are, more importantly. That's really what I want you to understand as well. You know, Dr. Ladd is an amazing soul. He's the founder of this institution. And one of the biggest things for this institution that's very important to him and all the faculty that are here and all of us administration and staff that support is always to remember the spiritual component of everything that we are doing. Because, you know, it's become cliche nowadays that, you know, body, mind, spirit, that whole thing, but it's true. It's so true, right? We are beyond just this physical being. We are more than our bones and our skin and our hair and our teeth and all that stuff, right? We have an emotional body. We have a psychological body. We have a mental body. We have a spiritual body. And how do we exist in relation with all of these? So at the Institute, we really emphasize understanding every component of this. So when you go through your journey, especially as a student of the first year program, I feel like it is a mental, emotional, spiritual detox that you are undertaking, to be perfectly honest. Yes, I'm going to get to all the nitty gritty nuances and the detail and the classes and all that stuff, but really it is a journey that is healing for ourselves, especially in that first year program, because you are learning a brand new language. And then when learning this language, right, different obstacles come our ways, different challenges come our ways. So it allows us in every moment, in every aspect of our relationship with each other and ourselves to understand, hey, what am I needing today? What is my body asking of me? What is my emotional state? How do I serve it? And in this, we start understanding more and more about ourselves. What things are truly serving us? What habit patterns have I created in my lifetime through my 20s and 30s and 40s and et cetera, whatever it may be? Are those things serving me? And not from a judgmental standpoint, right? To truly understand, what is it? What is my intention for this being, for this lifetime that I have? It's such a precious lifetime. You know, I heard this beautiful story that if I were to offer all of you, I said, I'm going to give you all a brand new car. Let's say I said that, right? And then I said, okay, this is going to be your only car that you have for your entire lifetime. What would you do with that car? Anyone, feel free. You can put it in the chat. You can unmute yourself. What would you do? Like, how would you exist with that car? If this is the only car that you will ever have in your lifetime, and I'm going to give it to you as a brand new one, what would you do? Yes, Destiny says, maintain it, cherish it. Yes. Yes. Take excellent care of it. Learn everything to keep it going. Take very good care of it. Yes, exactly. All of us would do the same thing. All of those answers, right? It's the same thing. We've been given this beautiful brand new body when we took birth, when we were born. This is the one body that we're going to have in this lifetime. So what do we need to do with it? Exactly what everyone is writing. We want to cherish it. We want to take excellent care of it. We want to understand everything about it so then we know what it needs to constantly keep it humming beautifully all the way along so it can serve us, right? That's what we do at the Ayurvedic Institute. We understand every aspect of this being, of the physical part, the mental part, the emotional part, the spiritual part. And we start looking at it from an Ayurvedic lens. You start understanding in basics of Ayurveda, right? We see the world from an elemental standpoint. We have the five basic elements that exist all throughout the world: ether, air, fire, water, and earth. Then we start understanding, how do these things combine in different proportions to start forming our doshas, which is vata, pitta, and kapha. And then within that, what are the qualities, which we call gunas, that are manifesting between these things? Because, for example, vata is ether and air elements put together. And then what are the qualities of ether and air, right? They are dry, they are light, they are rough, they are expansive, like there's no friction, there's no boundaries, no limitation, there's creativity. There's the spiritual aspect of it to go beyond the physical because there's no boundaries. This is all vata dosha. And these are all the qualities of vata dosha. But then we start understanding within our bodies throughout the year when you're enrolled in the program, okay, which of those qualities are manifesting in myself today? Which of those qualities are too much in myself today that might be causing havoc in my body, right? And the havoc we all experience, right? That's the aches and pains and all those things that we all go through. Or maybe the mental fog, or maybe the bouncing around, the lack of concentration, the lack of focus, the unsteadiness, like an unsure, doubtful, or even emotionally, like the fear, the anxiety. We start understanding all of these components from an Ayurvedic side, not from a good or bad or better or worse, because they're at the end of the day, what is it? It's all elements. It's all energy. There isn't a right or wrong or a good or bad. It's saying, what is serving us? What do I need in this moment? And then as soon as I understand, oh, this dry quality is too much in my body. It is not serving me. I am getting like dry, brittle hair. I'm getting dry nails, dry skin, dry lips, whatever it may be. And then we're like, oh, okay, it's not serving me well. Then, okay, how do I balance it, right? So one of the really simple principles of balance that I'll give you today in Ayurveda is you balance with the opposites. So then we say, okay, well, what is the opposite of dry, right? It's like unctuous, it's oily, it's lubrication, it's like juiciness, right? So then we say, okay, how do I bring all of that stuff within my body? And that can be brought in at all levels. Again, physical, emotional, mental, spiritual, right? Physically, I can start taking in more oils. I can eat good fats. I can have some avocado. Physically, externally, I can start applying oil to the skin to help myself out. Mentally and emotionally, what does dryness do, right? Dryness creates like a separation. Like if I have two sheets of paper right here, if they're dry, they're never going to stick together, right? So mentally and emotionally, I've got like the separation that I've created in my being. So then how do I bring that more into relationship, more into harmony with others, more into harmony with nature, more into harmony with myself? How do I create that unctuousness and juiciness within my being as well on a mental, emotional, spiritual level? So we start diving in and exploring all of these things. You have this beautiful class called Foundations of Ayurveda, which literally means taking you through the foundations of Ayurveda, kind of what we're talking about today. And then all your other classes help to support that and break it down so you understand every component of it. So then as we're talking in this example that I'm going through, you would start in your Ahar class, which means diet and like nutrition and food as medicine. You'll start understanding, okay, what foods are good for me to take in, depending on the quality that I'm trying to balance? What food should I avoid? Then you have a Vihar class, which means lifestyle. So saying, okay, what am I doing every day? What are my habit patterns? What's my routine? What is a daily routine that might be good for me? What are different activities and exercises, which leads into yoga class, that might be good for me? What are some different breathwork exercises or pranayama that might help me balance things? Then we also learn, as we're saying all of these things, right? We're learning a lot of the authentic Sanskrit scriptures along with it. So you actually learn Sanskrit. That is one thing that we really emphasize at the Ayurvedic Institute that I think many institutions don't, because we want you to feel comfortable, whether it's 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, you go through the entire doctoral program with us, but we want you to feel comfortable to be able to open up a book after year one and say, hey, I can read that, right? How fast you read it is just how much practice, right? Just like when we're first starting to learn our ABCs, same way, you just practice with it. But we want you to interact with Sanskrit. It has certain vibrations that are so healing. How many people have a mantra or are familiar with like using a mantra for healing purposes, for spiritual practice? Yeah. So why do we do those, right? Those mantras create a vibration. Not because one mantra is better than another or any of those things, but there's a vibration. Sound heals. That's why music therapy is so beautiful. It's a healing component of our beings. And then the science part, we want you to understand the science. There is a beautiful science around Ayurveda that works. There's logic behind it. So you also start understanding why it works, the physiology of Ayurveda. And then we combine it with, I guess, Western physiology. So you understand like anatomy and physiology. So when you're interacting with a client, or if it's just for yourself or your family members, you understand what's going on. So even if you had to interact with a medical professional and they're throwing out these medical terms, you're like, okay, I know what this is. And then you know how to translate this Western medical terminology into Ayurvedic terminology and do an integration. And that's a huge component that we emphasize in our school as well, because we live in the 21st century. Just the other day, Dr. Ladd was lecturing to the students and he was like, we have to be practical and we have to be relevant. We live in the 21st century. No matter where you live on this planet, we're all in this together. So you have to be able to communicate at all the various levels. And that's why we do a beautiful integrated approach. And integration for the Ayurvedic Institute is on both levels. One, understanding the allopathic and being able to integrate. And two, the integration of this mind, body, spirit phenomenon. And that's what it says. Like one of the very first sutras in Charak Samhita, which is a classical text of Ayurveda, talks about
these components of our being. So I would say that would be like a huge differentiating factor for our school. You know, if you really want to dive in, understand your being, understand yourself, and start healing yourself, go through it and experience it yourself, then that's where you need to come, to be honest with you. And then we do offer hybrid classes. So that means some online, some in person, but we are truly a beautiful in-person campus. We have a full campus connected to a beautiful yoga studio with so many different other healers around us and cafes and coffee shops. It's like, you know, the university, small college town feel when you're going to school and you're there with your peers, your classmates, your faculty members, you're able to chit chat. And then the other part of the spiritual component is we do a lot of celebrations. I'll be honest, we love celebrating, okay? There's always some kind of chai party or some kind of puja. And a puja means like a celebration and ceremony. Again, just honoring these different energies that come throughout the year, whether it's the energy of Ganesh or energy of Saraswati, like we've discussed, or energy of Hanuman, of like devotee and a servant's heart, you know, all these various energies we celebrate throughout the year with everyone as well. And then I would say another like differentiating thing that we have at our school is our clinic. It is huge. It is invaluable because what I found from, and I have many friends at other schools as well too, that even teach there, they're graduates of the Institute. But one thing that I've found that they have told me as well is they don't really have a true clinical support, where many of them are having to find, you know, their own clients and just experience it kind of on their own and then just send in a write-up essentially, which is not a bad thing necessarily, but in our clinic, we actually have faculty members that are with you. You are seeing physical people and we want you to be competent. Now in this day and age, just like, you know, we're on Zoom. Zoom is not going away. Online is not going away, no matter what our opinions may be of that. You know, I would love to just see everybody physically and in person and be able to like give it hugs all day long. But the world we live in is a different reality. So then you actually see clients on Zoom being supervised directly with a faculty member there and with your peer. So you're starting to understand and really experience Ayurveda on a very practical, clinical, relevant way. So you'll get to see clients online as well as in person at our student clinic. And our student clinic, you know, it's really for our community. So we just open it up. It's like a donation sliding scale basis. So we get all types of demographics, all types of ailments, which is what we want, right? We want that diversity. We want to help people. We want to support people wherever they are in their healing journey. And then as you get, you know, down the line, you go into ASP2, ASP3, you're able to do more things in that clinic, essentially, because you're able to do herbal formulas, you're able to do hands-on body work. And we have a beautiful relationship with a local massage school. And the founder of the massage school was amazing, to be honest with you. So those individuals where if the body work inspires you or you want to become a massage therapist, we have a beautiful connection with them where you get certain, you know, admission perks and everything to them, as well as discounted tuition rates with the massage school here in Asheville as well. And then let me just go through, I'm going to just scan through some of these questions because I know like Devang and Savin and all these guys are helping to answer some of them, but I just want to make sure. Student housing, Medina, man, fantastic question. That is one of our biggest wish list items, to be honest with you. We don't have like a formal, you know, like dormitory student housing, but we have a beautiful list. Again, Nishita and some of the other admissions team members, we have a list of like apartments that we've kind of vetted out a little bit when we first moved here, as well as individuals within the community that want to help support our students, where they'll rent out rooms, or if people want to do roommates. We have so many students even this year that are roommates, you know, or housemates together, where they'll rent something together. So we have those type of things, but not like a formal dormitory at this time. But that is one of our big wish list items. Let me see if there's...
Thank you.
Oh, of course. Of course. Let's see. I'm just looking school full time. Okay. Destiny. Beautiful question. So we do actually, Destiny's asking for those, so you don't have to scroll down the entire chat and messages. She's essentially asking, like, it would be difficult for her to do a full-time program. So we understand that. And we were finally able to get our approval last year. So this year we have it going on, and we will for future years too, is we have a part-time program for our first year program for this reason, Destiny. Whether you're, you know, a mom, you got to take a job, whatever it may be, or you just want to take it a little bit at a time. You know, you don't want to be a full-time student, whatever the reason is, but we do have the options of a part-time program. And Trevor is amazing at it. Savin knows it really well. Nishita knows it really well. But if you really are considering a part-time program, Trevor will be an individual that you end up with. We have options, you know, which courses to take and which courses build on each course. So that way, you know, okay, let me take this course this semester. Let me take this one the next semester. So it's in a nice sequential order for you as well. So we do have those options too, Destiny. So I hope that helps you without like going into that super, super detail right now. And can you be remote, Neha? Yes, my friend. You can be. There will be certain times that you are required to be in person, because in those, we're doing a lot of hands-on things too, right? So we want you to experience those. So there are predetermined times, you know, weeks at a time kind of thing throughout the year, where we will already have that laid out for you. So you'll know, okay, these dates, I just need to be in town. Because a lot of the schools, you know, they do remote stuff and it's like one weekend a month. But you know what? We learn in community. We heal in community. So it's super important for us. So we want you to come into Asheville. We want you to experience it. So there are those options. And then depending on what your case by case, you know, scenario is, we can go into more details about those on a one-on-one basis as well. Let's see. Is there an opportunity to learn about medicinal plants in ASP 1? Yes, Greta. We do like in AHAR class, we start learning about and you want to heal. Honestly, you're going to all these body work things, but at the end of the day, what am I, right? I am everything I consume. And it tells us what goes in through my senses. So if I can do everything that's in that, like, which is like 80 to 90% of my well-being, that is so important to us, Greta. So 100%, you start learning even just basic stuff. Like, what is the everyday food and how does it affect us? Even when I go to the grocery store, what are these things? What is seasonal? How do I start beginning to grow a garden? Different elements of all of that stuff. 100%. We value that very, very much. We have a bunch of amazing herbalists and plant medicine in, faculty members that really go into like herbology and ASP 2. One thing we are looking into, because, you know, we're new to Asheville, right? It's going to be our second graduation this June. So that's super exciting for us. But we've developed some beautiful relationships, even with like local herbologists and plant medicine guides. So we will be rolling out for our students, again, optional things, but this is part of the being in community. And like what you're saying, Greta, is understanding like local bioregional, like plant medicine and understanding those kind of things. And, you know, going on herb walks together and building that community as we're going through that and just start understanding and how to look at it. So whether your home is in Portugal or in Asheville or in Florida or, you know, in California, it doesn't matter where you live. If you start walking away and understanding how to interact with your environment, then you can interact with it anywhere you are in the world. So that's super important for us. I hope that helps, Greta. Awesome. Heidi has a similar question to Destiny to do the doctorate program sessions. Yeah, yeah. So I think I answered that, Heidi. And again, we can definitely set up a more one-on-one call to go through that in more detail for you as well, of like okay, you're in Iceland. What does that look like for you? Right. So we can go through that. And especially if you're going to, once you graduate, if you're going to be practicing in Iceland versus practicing in America. So we can go through all those nuances with you. And what does that mean for you?
Thank you.
Of course. Let's see. I'm just scrolling through. I want to try to get through as many questions as possible. Can I pick and choose the classes as a part-time program? Yes, my friend, Amit Kumar. Yes, you can. There are like certain prerequisites, right? Just like what I was saying, we want you to follow along. We don't want you to get lost. So there will be certain times like, oh, in order to take this class, you should take, you know, this other class prior to that. And that's only created just like in a college system, like a prerequisite. So you're not lost in that class. But yes, and Trevor would be the guy to talk to, Amit, for that. He can really guide you and explain, okay, well, this class will build these type of understanding, which will then help you into this class. You know, for example, it's like, we wouldn't want you to take clinic in trimester one, right? It wouldn't make any sense. You need to have your AHAR class. You need to have your foundations class. You need to have your VHAR class, because then those are the things that you're going to use as your recommendations and your tools when you're in clinic. So 100%. What is the frequency for hybrid? How often are you required to come? It will be usually a couple of weeks or so, based on, it's all based on regulation strategy. If you can hear me, how many weeks we require, how many hours, all those type of things. It's all based on our regulations of how much time needs to be in person. So usually it's a few weeks every trimester or so. It has not been determined yet, like exact dates for next year. We're in the process of determining that right now. So in the next few weeks, we will have that determined once we get all of the information back from all of our regulatory boards and stuff too.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, of course. Let's see. How many courses are we taking a trimester? Ooh, Greta, good one. So it does fluctuate from trimester to trimester. If you haven't received our catalog, definitely, you know, put that little submission in to get the catalog. And in the catalog, it actually breaks it down for you of what does it really look like by trimester. But think you will have, you know, like this nutrition AHAR class, you'll have a VHAR class, you have anatomy and physiology, you have a foundations class every trimester, because it will take you the entire year to get those foundations in. And the way we do it is it has some repetition built in. So that way we really understand. And with the repetition, every time we dive a little bit deeper, we gain another level of depth into all of these concepts as we're going through the year as well. Let's see. Could we earn hours? Yes. Oh, I love that, Tiffany. Okay. If Nishita was here, she'd be like celebrating and, you know, doing little balloon icons and emojis, because she loves yoga. Yoga is her dharma. Yes, you can. We have a beautiful YTT program. I'm glad you asked, because I would have probably forgotten to talk about it, honestly, Tiffany. You take yoga during the school year, you have it throughout the year. And in that, you're learning not only just asanas, but you're learning it from an Ayurvedic perspective, just like Dr. Ladd calls it Ayur yoga. So it's yoga overlaid with Ayurveda. So then when you're learning an asana, let's say even downward dog or warrior pose, anything, right? The asanas don't change. The asanas are the asanas. But then we say, okay, if someone is coming to you or yourself, you know, let's say you have a vata imbalance, how do you modify that asana? How can they do stuff to support their imbalances to get them back into balance? So we call that Ayur yoga. So you have that throughout the year. And then we have a particular YTT dedicated to Ayur yoga all the way up to 500 hours. So 200 hour and then a 300 hour. And then part of our doctorate program that we have, the 3 and 4 year program that we have, it includes it. It is part of this 500 hour YTT is included as part of that entire program. But even if you come just for 1 year or 2 years, you could definitely still be part of that YTT piece. And then again, like I said, Nishita, this is like her area of expertise. So she would be someone that you could definitely talk to in more detail if yoga is your passion, Tiffany. Let's see, Britt. Okay, looks like it's been answered. Awesome. Awesome. Okay. So I think I kind of covered most of it. Let's see. Yeah. Cause a lot of them have some beautiful chat answers too. So thank you, Savin. Thank you, Devang, as well. And then please, yeah, definitely feel free to keep asking questions. Are there any other?
Sorry to interrupt you, Sneha.
No, please.
Hey, it's Sanjay. Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
I had a question up there. I think because of, so you had to scroll quite a bit, you may have missed it. I just wanted to get a little bit more flavor of the hybrid approach, specifically in the context of residency. So I'm based in Washington, D.C. area. I know Asheville is a beautiful place, but I, you know, just logistically, it may be a bit challenging to move down to Asheville. I know you guys are offering this remote hybrid approach. Can you, what does that mean? And what does that mean, like, in terms of, am I full time sitting in classes from 8 to 6, or is it something that I look at videos later on? How will that work if I have to be fully immersed in it?
Got it. No, great question. So variety of different options. And this is where also Sanjay G and anyone else with a similar, you know, scenario or question, we can definitely do a one-on-one with everyone, but you have a variety of different options. So let's say you want to do a full-time program and that's all you're going to do. Then you could do that, you know, with this hybrid option where you are on Zoom, just like we are doing it right now. So that way you're able to interact with the teachers, because we don't, you know, we're more about synchronous hours. So that way you have that interaction with your teachers, with your classmates, and you can do it that way. Or you can also, you have the option, like if you are, let's say you're working or you have family or whatever it may be, and you're doing a part-time thing. Similarly, you can do the part-time program in the same manner. So you could do it from DC, but there will be certain just times, like what I was saying, that certain number of hours have to be in person. So again, once we get that exact number for this year, you know, we'll be rolling that out for next year. So then you'll get that. So you'll know way in advance of like, okay, these are the dates that I need to be in person, you know, to meet my in-person requirements kind of thing.
Okay, that helps.
Now, I just want to build on Shah's question, because I think the timing, the number of hours per day is also important here, Snehaji. So if you could elaborate on that so that we can kind of plan our year accordingly.
100%. So again, it'll vary a little bit based on if you're part-time or if you're full-time. Full-time, then it is a good class load, my friends. Okay. So I'll tell you one thing that, you know, every year this is kind of funny because every year at the end of the year, we go through and we review all the curriculum, all the syllabi for every single class for every single year, first year, second year, third year, fourth year, everything, right? With Dr. Ladd. And every year we're like, you know, regulations only requires us, like, for example, for the first year program, 600 hours. That's what most schools are offering. Our program is like, you know, over 800 hours kind of thing. It has a lot of stuff in it. So if you are full-time, it is a full-time commitment. But if you're part-time, then, you know, depending on which classes you choose, you might just be going like half day. You might just have like one or two classes in the morning, or one class in the morning, or one class in the afternoon, depending on, you know, which classes you've chosen to attend. So it really varies based on if you're doing full-time or part-time. But the reason I say the story is because we just feel that is so important, you know, to get the foundations, the way we've built out the program, it is more than what regulations requires. You know, we're kind of like the gold standard, I think, to really give you everything, because we want to make sure whether you graduate as a first year or you graduate as a fourth year or anything in between, we want to make sure everyone graduates with confidence and with competency. That is super important. And we take that very serious. At the end of the year, you know, we are understanding and applying all of that every single year and reassessing constantly of like, okay, what are the tweaks? What do we want to change? How do we make it better? Always, always, always looking for what can we do the best and to be able to offer the most and the best to each of you as well in all aspects. Does that help, Nehaji?
Yes, it does. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Yes. Awesome. Awesome. And then Destiny has a great question too. Meditation and the spiritual thread and everything. You know, one thing I've really just learned and admired about Dr. Laji is his openness and his acceptance to all. Honestly speaking, he is a beautiful human being that has experienced a variety of things in his lifetime, right? He is like 80 plus. I don't know the exact age. So I've been saying 80 plus for so many years now. So he's maybe in the mid 80s by now. I know exactly. But he is so open and so kind and just so accepting to everything, every faith. And it's really about, for us, especially in our first year program, exposing all of you to all of that, because what serves me today may not be the same thing that I need 2 months from now, right? What serves me today from a food side, from a meditation side, from an activity, anything may change based on how I am changing on all dimensions, you know, tomorrow, a week from tomorrow, 2 months from now. So from a meditation side, you do learn a variety of different meditation techniques, and no one technique is better or worse. Honestly, it is what is serving you. What is it that you need in that moment? You must experience that. And we want you to experience everything that we can give you. Essentially, we'll have different teachers teach you a variety of different techniques, variety of different breathing techniques that can lead into meditation. So hopefully that helps to answer that also, Destiny. It's not about one technique, this is better, this is worse, or any of those things. And you'll find that echoing kind of throughout everything that we are teaching you. It's not about a good or bad or a judgment. It's more about the experience and understanding of it. You know, we encourage our students as they're learning different things to experiment within themselves and say, okay, well, how did that make me feel? You know, what happened to my body? What happened to my spirit? What happened to my emotions? What happened to my digestion and my agni, right? So then you really start understanding that, and you're able to help offer that guidance to others then. And Anna, oh, great question. Yes, my friend, we do have an orientation. Super important. We really, really value that orientation. And we go through a lot of these things that we're talking about today. And we kickstart you in that orientation with Vihar, with Dinacharya, with like routine and lifestyle and what it means and what's happening to you today with all this new stuff, right? Entering into a new program, a transition, all these things. So orientation is super important for us. And you start to meet all your classmates. You meet all of your faculty. We're having lunches together. You know, we're understanding each other because this is our community. This is how we heal together. This is how we support each other. It doesn't happen in isolation. It truly happens in a village and a community setting. And we want everyone to have those relationships. We value that tremendously. And then Julie, yes, my friend, we can definitely talk more offline about the doctorate level program. And it is 2 years, and it goes actually into like specialties and immersions. You get more into the allopathic science as well. Like you start understanding lab reports and blood work. So when a client comes to you, especially at that level, and they're saying, hey, my TSA is this, and this is my blood lipid panel, and this is what's going on with my blood pressure, and they give you all these different things, we want you to feel comfortable with that. We want you to understand that. So you can talk to a doctor, you can talk to their medical practitioner and be able to support them through Ayurveda. You also learn pharmacology in the doctoral program. And then we have specialty immersions. You do this beautiful deep dive into women's health in the doctoral program. And one of our faculty members is a doctor and is a specialist. She's an OB-GYN. So you get to actually rotate and round with her at the hospitals. You get to see, you know, deliveries and surgeries. And then you say, okay, you're not a surgeon by any means, but how do you support an individual that's going to go through surgery or post-surgery? Or how do you support a mom that is pregnant in X trimester? And how do you support them postpartum after the delivery? What's happening to them? You get to really interact with all of these clients. Another beautiful immersion that we have in that doctorate program is you get to travel to India with Dr. Ladd. You get to see him in his hometown, in his home clinic, and really understand and start experiencing Panchakarma with him. He takes you through Panchakarma, seeing Panchakarma clients, understanding even the Indian herbs that may or may not be available, you know, definitely in America, but depending on where you are in the world as well. And then one other immersion that we take you through in the doctoral program is we have a partnership with Banyan Botanicals, and they have this beautiful farm, and Greta may enjoy this, is they have a farming internship that we've really curated just for our program. So there you get lectures there, but you get hands-on farming there, which is so cool. Like from the seedling to harvesting to then what do you do with that? How do you create plant medicine, right? What are different oils or grithams or tinctures or different things that you can create? And you know, Banyan's awesome with all of that stuff, with all their products and everything. So you get to actually be there on their Banyan farm with all of their experts and teachers and everything too. And then we do actually, our school is very lucky. I don't know how many schools have this, but we are actually authorized to give, because I just saw like, you know, about international stuff, Brent. We are authorized to give educational visas. And again, Nishita helps to answer and like do all the paperwork and work with each person that is traveling internationally and to authorize those visas and things like that. So we have a lot of individuals from all over the world every year that, you know, we issue visas so they can travel to America and, you know, do the program and all that, those things too. So these are fantastic questions. And, you know, I just really appreciate the excitement around all of this stuff and the questions and, you know, your engagement in the whole process. And our intention, honestly, is whether you study with us or not, you know, study Ayurveda, no matter what. The world needs it, honestly speaking. The world needs competent individuals, confident individuals that are truly rooted in this science and in the spiritual component of it, because everyone needs healing. Everyone needs healing. It doesn't matter. We've all faced some sort of physical, mental, emotional trauma in our lives, and we all need that support. And Ayurveda just needs to go to all corners of the world. So I support you learning Ayurveda everywhere. Of course, at the Ayurvedic Institute, I have a bias, you know, I think we're the best. I think we're awesome. I graduated from the program. Most of our faculty have graduated from the program. We have a lot of doctors that have graduated from our program that then integrate within their practice. So of course I have a bias, you know, but at the end of the day, we want individuals to heal. We want you to study Ayurveda, you know, whatever that may be for you and wherever that may be for you as well. Awesome. Any other last minute questions? We only have a few more minutes. So I just want to make sure. And I really just appreciate all the chat responses too, because I know I'm trying to like keep up with it and talk. So it gets a little hairy at times. Is there a chronological age at which someone might be lovingly encouraged to reconsider? I love that, Sarah. You're so sweet the way you said that too. You know, honestly, no. I'll give you an example. We have a variety of individuals. We have people straight from high school to individuals in their mid 70s. So everyone is welcomed. It does not matter at the end of the day. If you have a sincere desire, a sincere fire in your heart to learn this, then you can learn it, honestly. I wouldn't discourage anyone. Once you're in the program, all of the faculties, I mean, they go out of their way to support you. Is there effort? Is there rigor? 110% there is, right? You have to meet everyone halfway there, because you're going to change the world. When you graduate, you're going to work with human beings. You're going to have their lives in your hands. And we want you to feel so confident and competent. Anyone that you work with, they're going to be like, oh yeah, Sarah knows what she's talking about. I feel really comfortable to be in her hands, you know, or whoever it may be. So is there work? 110% there is, man, but it is worth it, my friends. I'm telling you, you feel so amazing, especially that first client interaction that you have. And we start you guys off even observing our second years and our third years, even starting off in trimester one. So you really start getting clinic, and you start seeing all the dynamics, and you see how everything will start coming together for you. And then in trimester three of the first year program, you're going to have your own clients. You're going to actually see people, and we don't like make up people, you know, they're real people that are coming to our clinic, whether online or in person, that need help, that need support. So we want you to be there for them for sure. So to your question, Sarah, no, my friend, everyone is welcomed, all demographics, all ages, all, you know, ethnicities and backgrounds, and anything you say, we really value diversity because that's how we learn from each other as well. That's how we support each other. And there's always something new that we can all learn and benefit from. Let's see. Oh, beautiful, Shruti. If you are already a doctor, again, we can talk because obviously if you're a practicing medical professional, of whether it's a doctor, a nurse, an occupational therapist, physical therapist, whatever it may be, we can talk and we can have a one-on-one. Like we can set it up with Savin or Trevor or Nishita or myself or anyone, but there'll be certain things that obviously you'd be exempt from, you know, like you wouldn't have to take anatomy and physiology. You've taken a lot of anatomy and physiology being a doctor already, and how the whole integration would work. So there's different things like that, where if you already have something, then you can be exempt from it as well. And another quick question I thought I saw, or maybe I read it too fast, but, many individuals also, you know, if they've completed the first year program at another school, then there is an option to test into our second year program as well. So don't feel like you have to like go through the entire first year program again, but we do have a examination that you have to complete, because we've just noticed, you know, with the extra hours that we offer in our program, in the first year program, many individuals, you know, that you may or may not receive everything that we give as a school. So we just want to make sure that you feel really comfortable going into that second year program. So we do have a little test-in option for our second year program too. Awesome. Thank you, Julie. What are the academic prerequisites for the first year? So you do not have to have any sort of medical background, if that's what you're kind of going towards, Sarah. We have individuals, like I said, straight out of high school, right? The basic that we are required to have from our regulatory boards is a high school diploma or equivalency. So even if you're international, it should just have some sort of equivalency to that. But you don't have to have like a college degree or any kind of college prerequisites or any kind of medical background. We have individuals from finance and business and yoga and medical doctors and everything in between. So don't worry, like from that medical side, if that's what you are asking. It's just that high school equivalency or, you know, high school diploma. No, my friend, no anatomy or biology courses are required, because that's why we actually include anatomy and physiology in our program in the first year. And then again, if you're medical background, then we don't make you sit through that whole thing. You know, there's an exemption process in that as well. But for those that don't have it, we have a beautiful teacher. She's a massage therapist, a nurse, you know, has an active practice, and she actually takes you through anatomy and physiology, and she's a beautiful, beautiful human being. All right. Well, we are coming. I can't believe an hour went by so fast. I guess I can't talk for an hour, because I was like, oh, without Nishita, what am I going to talk about? But I guess I can't talk for an hour. How about we wrap it up? We'll do one of our closing prayers that we do. And it's just bringing everyone together. And you may have heard it as well too. So if you want, same thing, just relax, let go of everything. And I sincerely hope this has been an informative session for you and helpful. And we do look forward to connecting with each of you. If you have more questions one-on-one, definitely reach out. So many people out there to help you. And just, again, just sincere gratitude for your love for Ayurveda, wherever it may, you know, lead you in your like course of study and your course of healing. I truly appreciate that because the world needs it. Karin, just gently close your eyes. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahano Bhunaktu, Saha Viryam Karvavahai, Tejasvina Vaditamastu, Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Namaste, everyone. Hope you have a fantastic weekend. And I hope I see you next year so I can give you a hug during orientation. Bye. Much love.